so many handbags, so many, crazy many, a lot. Hi, this is Erin from What Would the Neighbors Think? It's the place where women learn how to build wardrobes that make them shine. And we're talking handbags today. And I'm gonna help you find the ones that you need. There are only three of them. Believe it or not, you just need three bags in your wardrobe. Now, of course, if you want the ultimate collection, you're gonna want more than three. But when you're starting out, you need three basic bags. But from totes to satchels to crossbodies to clutches, it can be overwhelming. So I'm going to show you what you need to know when you're buying any handbag. And I'm going to also help you find the look for less. We'll look at what you need, and then we're going to look at a few fun things as well. I've got a post that I keep updated with all the shopping links and the latest stuff that the stores are showing in handbags. So I'll make sure that you get that link down below. Now, if you stick around till the end, I'm going to show you a favorite bag of mine from my own collection. See what you think. Anyway, let's get to it. The right handbag really can make the outfit, and at a minimum, you need three. You need a daily workhorse, a weekender, and an out-on-the-towner. Now, each of these bags has a specific job, and the one can't do the job of the other. You're going to see what I mean soon. Let's start with the daily workhorses. This is a practical handbag with the integrity to withstand a lot of use. It's your main bag. You're looking for quality that lasts, so buy the best you can afford. A classic design is well worth an investment because it won't go out of style. You want it to be big enough to carry what you need, whether that's a laptop or even a baggie of Cheerios for the kids. But no matter what your price range, there are a few timeless styles to consider in this category. The satchel handbag. This workhorse has a divided interior so that you can quickly find what you need. It's most often structured and perfect for work environments. It often has two handles, one that's a top handle as well as a shoulder strap. The hobo handbag has a more casual look. It's unconstructed and generally pretty roomy inside, but avoid the temptation to overfill it. The look should remain slouchy, not stuffed. Again, you're going to get the links to everything that I'm showing you. Another workhorse is the shoulder bag. The shoulder bag comes in a variety of sizes, but should easily tuck under your arm. The iconic quilted Chanel handbag with its double chain handle is one of the originals. The double chains offer a jewelry-like effect and can be separated to convert to a crossbody style. If you can afford to buy two workhorse bags, get one to go with cool colors like black, blue, and gray, and one to go with warm colors like brown, tan, and olive. Ideally, figure out whether you wear more cool tones or warm tones and spend more on that bag since it's going to be the one getting more use. Now, if you can only do one, a cognac-colored handbag, which is burgundy, can handle both warm and cool colors. And now the weekenders. These are the purses you use for more casual occasions. They don't necessarily need to be as substantial as the workhorses, but you'll still need to frequently use them for hands-free outings like shopping and other weekend fun. First, the tote bag. In sturdy leather, this is strong enough to be a workhorse, but in softer constructions, it's perfect for casual weekends, shops, and markets. Either way, this is made for running errands. Now, pouches. You're probably going to need a couple of these for really large handbags like totes, hobos, gym bags, or beach bags. They keep all the little things in an easy-to-find spot, and they also make switching purses effortless. Many tote bags come with removable matching pouches, but you can also use anything from makeup bags to pencil cases. Have fun with these. The third weekender is the crossbody handbag. When you need your hands free, this is the go-to bag. Think shopping, concerts, amusement parks. If you're busty, the strap can annoyingly cut you right in two. If that's the case, try wearing the bag closer to being in front of your stomach than on your hip. The out-on-the-towners. Now, these are the bags you use when you're dressed up and you just need to carry a few things. The workhorses and the weekenders are just too bulky or casual for these occasions and for these outfits.
The clutch. Oh, I love a clutch. There's something so chic and feminine about it. Because they're small, you can go all out with the design without worrying it'll be too busy with your outfit. Think of them as decorative jewelry. And if you hate the idea of having something constantly under arm, many of them come with a hidden strap you can put around your wrist or over your shoulder. The evening bag. Now these are special. Many sparkle with dazzling embellishments while others are sleek and understated. Like special jewelry, they elevate your nighttime look. When they're not in use, they're like little pieces of art that can beautifully decorate an accessory shelf. Now, just an etiquette note on these two, and really any handbag for that matter. When you're out dining, no matter how pretty your handbag is, it's not appropriate to put it on the table. It should rest on your lap, under your napkin, or behind your back, or on a chair next to you. Or you can use one of these clever little purse hooks. They have a rubberized back and they open up to hook onto a tabletop, so you have a convenient place to hang your bag wherever you go. This set of four goes for about $12.
So that's a minimum of three handbags for your wardrobe. No arguments. A big structured handbag is not going to look good with a sweet little summer dress or a pair of shorts. And it's definitely going to be out of place with a cocktail dress. So you got to get three. Now, luckily, you don't need to spend a fortune to get the right look, but you do need to know what you're looking for to get quality that lasts. So here are some guidelines for you when buying any handbag.
Nylon and canvas bags are definitely more casual. Keep this in mind if you need something that's work appropriate. While leather and faux leather bags are versatile enough to go from work to weekend. Keep weight in mind. Make sure it's not too heavy empty. You don't want straps digging into your shoulder once you've filled it with what you need. Make sure it opens and closes easily, has a wide enough opening, and will easily accommodate your phone and other items you always carry. Zippers should glide smoothly, and magnets should catch and release easily. Otherwise, any stress will eventually wear the bag down. Both the handbag and the lining should have quality stitching. There shouldn't be any loose threads. It's super frustrating to lose something beneath the lining of the bag. The straps should be strong enough and well stitched to the bag, since this is where the most stress is placed.
Now some tips for when you're trying to find the look for less.
As for inexpensive bags, dark colors tend to look richer, and they better mask lower quality leathers. If the bag is nylon, the fabric should be somewhat thick. It looks more expensive and it lasts longer. Unless they are high-end luxury bags, prominent logos can actually cheapen the look of your bag. A well-done look for less could be mistaken for a high-end bag if it doesn't have any telltale name on it. Hardware should be somewhat thick and substantial. The brass or the silver should have some weight to it. If patterned, the print should match up at the seams. This is a detail of high-end bags, and it might be harder to find on more affordable purses. Some patterns will match up better than others. Just choose one that's not too obvious. Most importantly, experience quality. Learn what kind of details make something expensive.
I've given you my choices in each category at a variety of price ranges. Now, if the high-end bags are out of your price range, take a look at them anyway. I want you to understand what makes a bag expensive. This is how you learn how to find quality, how to find a look for less. You need to understand the details. Ideally, you look in person and you can feel the leather, you can feel the hardware, and really see what that looks like, so that when you are out shopping, you can find something that kind of mimics it and does a good job of copycatting, I guess. This is the same advice that I give to my clients and, I mean, anybody when it comes to buying accessories, clothing, anything for your wardrobe. You want to experience the highest quality that you can, because you'll learn what it is that makes those items expensive. And then you're able to go out and mimic that, to find that and really get a good look for less. After you've got your basics covered, there's a few fun things to consider too. Now, if you're going for the ultimate collection that every girl deserves, you're going to want to take a look at these. So just really quick, these are job-specific bags.
Or you could call it the That's My Jobbers. Anyway, the newest addition is the phone carrier. This little gem's great for when all you need is your phone and maybe a credit card. It's kind of like an out for a walk bag. The weekend getaway bag. It's the just going away for one or two nights bag. Don't bother with a suitcase or settle for an old duffel bag. You want to go away in style instead. The gym bag, with tough tech construction, a special spot for dirty clothes, and just the right amount of compartments. These are going to get you back and forth from the gym, keeping everything in its place. The beach bag. It's great to have a bag specifically designated for the beach or pool. Just leave your sunscreen, magazines, sand toys, sand in it until the next time. This is where a pouch comes in extra handy. It's a nice dry place to keep your phone, your keys, and any other purse items. And the diaper bag. This becomes your every single day bag. You need something functional that matches your style and that daddy's not going to mind carrying around. Don't worry about finding one that converts to a regular handbag afterwards. Believe me, by then you're going to be ready to see it go.
As I said, there's a post that I keep all the shopping links updated on, and that's going to be down below. It's called the Essential Handbag Collection. Now, be sure to subscribe and click that little bell so that it notifies you whenever I put anything out that has to do with discovering your style, editing your closet, or shopping like a stylist. Do you guys want to see my handbag? Ooh. Okay, this is my favorite handbag. This one is Gucci, and it was made when Tom Ford was there designing for them. I don't usually get starstruck, but he's so charming. He's totally handsome. Anyway, he signed it for me right in here. I'll show it to you in here. And I don't know, I just love it. But I hope that this guide helped you to find your bag that you're going to be falling in love with just as much. Thanks so much, and I'll see you next time. There are a lot of handbags, like way a lot. Too many. A lot. Lots. Tips for when you're trying to find the look for less. You're looking for less? All right, handbags. We're talking handbags. Oh my God. Ah. Gucci, 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 Gucci. Calm down. All right. Make sure to hook that to you down below. Show you a few fun things too. Slam. Okay. I'm not sure what I'm going to say. You really need to know what you're looking for. I've got hair in my mouth. Right there, in my mouth. Now here are some looks. Look! Anyway. I think I got it.